Hey there, Lego lovers. It's me, Blair Archer, welcoming you into the Brix Lego Studio for another exciting and educational element exploration. Let's take a look inside the Lego idea set and see what we're going to be working on today. Ooh, a planet. That means we're going to take a look at what makes the Lego world go round, or in other words, how to create spherical structures and what elements are good for using as round pieces in your own builds. Join me over at the Lego desk and let's take a look at how you can use spheres in your Lego creations. Come on. Woo! Let's get spherical. Checking out this particular sphere that we pulled out of the Lego Ideas head, you can see that it is a planet and it is actually a Lego Star Wars container. A few years back, they used to put some sets similar to the microfighters inside these, and this was included with the parts to build the little creation. This is probably the most accurate Lego sphere that you'll find, just because technically it's impossible to make an actual Lego sphere, since a sphere has infinite points of curvature along the outside. And a Lego creation will oftentimes have more of a geodesic shape, some kind of dodecahedron or a multiple of sides that is large enough to create a rounded shape, but not technically a sphere. On that note, however, let's take a look at some rounded elements that are particularly useful in creating Lego spheres. When you think about Lego, a lot of it is bricks and angular pieces, but we have lots of rounded elements in our assortment. We got wheels and dishes of varying sizes, including small rounded elements. We also have some pre-existing spheres in the Lego system. Small balls like this, some of which are translucent, some of which are weighted from the Harry Potter series. The others have been used in little shooting elements and random sets here and there, as well as certain balls from Duplo and from the Mindstorm systems, which are rarer but have been found to be useful. If you're looking for things to emulate small balls or spheres in your Lego creations, perhaps minifigure scale, these little Technic ball joint elements are oftentimes used to represent a ball. It has an open spot on the bottom where a Technic cross axle can go inside it, but it can also stick onto a stud, so you can just place it in an environment like this and you'll have yourself a little rounded shape. Even tinier pieces can be represented by the little ice cream scoop slash cloud bubbly sort of piece. It has four small balls stacked in a pyramid. Another pre-existing sphere-like piece is this interesting ball joint assembly, which consists of a cup or socket like this and two halves of a sphere, which you insert into the open shell and create a little ball joint that can move around inside there. Very interesting pieces. However, you cannot use these elements outside of the socket to create a sphere very easily. They did have some really interesting ones though. I believe these were used as creepy eyes in an undersea creature. We also have some exciting domes, which can be useful for creating a spherical shape in your environment, but creating an entire sphere is very difficult with these. Some folks have done it to make little pokeballs and the like, but they involved using rubber bands as well as some assembly off to the side that kind of interrupted the spherical shape anyway. But they are really pretty to look at. Certain windscreens, however, have been designed to create as close to a spherical shape as possible, like this, which came out of the gyrosphere rides from the Jurassic World series. You can connect the two sides using Technic elements and create a rolling enclosure. You can also use this windscreen to create a pretty awesome sphere. Even though it does have a mounting system connected to it, if you take two of them and put them along a plate and then close them up together, you can get a pretty cool connected bubble. It's not 100% perfect, but for attaching to a vehicle or the side of a research base or using it for some sort of a bubble in any kind of creation, it definitely gets that effect. And it looks pretty awesome. It can also still open and close while mounted on there. So if you're looking for something that has sort of a spherical head or mouth system, it can be good for that kind of a creation as well. We also have some excellent dome elements and quarter dome elements out there that can make for really cool sphere-like shapes, and we're going to touch on these when we get into some techniques in a little bit. Even though we're pushing ourselves to think outside of the blocks here, these are perfect examples of how you can build a Lego sphere using even the simplest of elements. Using just some regular bricks in different varieties, you can create a sphere by using a stacked system going in by one stud for each layer. You can create a really realistic sculptural type spherical shape. This is the kind of brick building that you will see oftentimes at Legoland or in exhibits like The Art of the Brick by Nathan Sawaya. Whenever you see larger brick sculptures, a lot of this kind of math has been used to create the curvature. Let's crack one open and take a look inside. Let's see what the structure looks like. You can see that it becomes an interesting network of interlocking bricks. The key being that everything, as you get smaller towards the ends of the sphere, at the top and the bottom, is supported underneath or partially by some of the other bricks that are interlocked. What a cool building technique. And once you squish them back together, they're actually really sturdy and can even roll around. Speaking of rolling, let's get rolling on taking a look at a different kind of technique that you can use to create spheres. For this one, we're going to use one of these Travis bricks, which is a snot type of brick, or studs not on top brick, where they have studs on every side except the bottom. We're going to use this to create a very awesome small sphere designed by a builder called Umamin. It uses the flower elements and the inverted 2x2 round tile to connect to every single side of this Travis brick at the same time. The design of the flower element is critical to this technique. In particular, we are using the four-petaled element, and these petal pieces can actually fit between the studs and slide right down in there. And so we do that for each side, popping them together. And then we can place them on each side of the Travis brick. And they will interlock with one another. And then I think for the bottom one, we do it the opposite direction, and we place the flower stem with the stud up, since we needed to go the other way. And in it goes. And there you have an awesome tiny sphere. For for this scale, it's an excellent way to create a little rounded object. And hey, it rolls too. Next up, one of the most popular snot-based spherical designs of all time is the Lowell sphere. Here you can see how a Lowell sphere goes together, using repeating shapes and, again, the Travis bricks and their studs on all sides capabilities, you're able to build in all six directions, and using the plate stepping between each layer, you can see that you create a rounded-like shape for each side. Here I've used this modified Lowell sphere. I've grown the shape a little bit and created a small moon with a rocket launch station in a classic space style. You can see that it creates sort of a six-sided die-like structure, and that you simply use each side and elements on it to create as rounded or smooth of a side as you wish. In this case, instead of using the Travis bricks in the corner, I've used some larger snot bricks. Here too is another technique where you use snot tricks in order to incorporate those dome elements into a sphere by Jaden Irwin. A clever use of the rounded slopes and the snot bricks on the inside of the structure allows you to make two halves out of the dome shapes fit together in a fairly spherical-like shape. You can also create a wireframe structure for making a spherical shape. In the LEGO Ideas Globe set, they used Technic elements like these and strung Technic bricks on the outer edges to create a sphere for the globe, and placed panels of plates on the outside in order to create the surface of the Earth. You can see in these pictures from the Brothers Brick how the construction was completed. Checking out the inside of the globe, you can see that the structure is an intricate array of interlocking elements that give us this sphere-like exterior. They even put in counterbalances so that the globe would spin accurately. Awesome! Well, thanks so much for joining me here in the Brix LEGO Studio to learn how to build everything from tiny little balls to awesome orbital objects. Whether you're working on something huge or small, remember, whatever you make is always going to be amazing, and I'm here for you if you have any questions. Feel free to reach out and let me know if you're stumped on a build or if you're looking for a new technique to solve what it is you're trying to make. Thanks again for joining us, and until next time, hit those bricks and play well. Bye!